So 50% of the human brain is dedicated to the act of seeing. Now, this might seem like an overestimation, but imagine the act of hitting a baseball. You see a pitcher wind up, release the ball, you see the ball coming towards you, you tense your muscles, swinging the bat, connecting with the ball. Think about how we communicate. We communicate through the written word, through the internet. Think about how we express ourselves through visual arts, photography, television, movies. There's simply no question we are visual creatures. There are more than 2 million people in the United States that suffer from photoreceptor diseases. And of these people, some 400,000 are blind. And as the population increases and people live longer, we only expect this number to increase. We expect it to increase by 50% in the next 10 years alone. And sadly, we're still at a point where there are no options. There are no FDA-approved treatments, nothing they can do. Now, that's not to say that people aren't working on it. People have been working on it for centuries. Go back 250 years ago, Charles Leroy would apply electrical current to his patient's skull as a way to try to restore some visual perception. In one instance, he's recalling, in addition to provoking terrible cries due to the pain of the electrical current, the patient perceived a flame that rapidly descended before his eyes. Now, unfortunately, the next 100 years didn't really improve the technology very much. This is an image of Duchenne. He's on the right there, applying electrical current to his patient. The difference here is this person was actually sighted. What he's trying to do is induce blindness as a way of trying to understand how we see. Now, fast forward another 100 years. This is Giles Brindley. He created the first implantable visual prosthesis. It would be implanted on the back of the head, on the occipital lobe, stimulating the visual cortex. He would do this to try to restore some visual sight. And unfortunately, this is the 1960s. The technology was still quite early, and the cost way too much to warrant a therapy. So the project was dropped. The eye is the first stage of seeing. Light enters through the cornea and the lens, hitting the retina, which consists of a series of different cell types, the photoreceptors, the bipolar cells, and ganglion cells. And so as light enters, it goes through the ganglion and bipolar cells, activating the photoreceptors, and this is exactly how we see. People that suffer from retinal degenerative diseases lose photoreceptors and simply have no way of capturing light. However, the bipolar cells and ganglion cells still remain. So the question is, what happens if we were able to make these cells light sensitive? Could we restore some functional vision? Through a massive collaboration here at USC, MIT, the University of Florida, and EOS Neuroscience, we are taking a gene that encodes a light-sensitive protein from an algae, introducing it into a virus. These are viruses that have been used in 36 different human clinical trials currently, and essentially create a gene therapy that allows cells to be light-sensitive. We inject these viruses into the eye. These viruses then infect the cells, dropping off that DNA that encodes that light-sensitive protein. Light-sensitive proteins are produced within the bipolar cells, and then these cells are now sensitive to light. Let me show you a little bit of data. These are mice that have been trained on a water maze task. They're taught to swim to a light source that has a platform. Mice are actually quite good swimmers, but they don't like water very much. So let me show you the first video. These are normally sighted mice. You'll see that after a fair amount of training, they can swim directly to that light. Now, they're not always perfect, but they quickly self-correct and will ultimately hit that target. On the flip side of this, we have mice that are fully blind. These represent what we see in people: retinitis pigmentosa, age-related macular degeneration. And again, after 2 weeks of training, they navigate around the maze, but they can't use visual information to get there. They'll feel their way around the walls, going from one tunnel to the next, to the next, to the next, until they ultimately reach their target. And finally, these are mice that have lost their photoreceptors, but now have light-sensitive bipolar cells. So these are mice that were blind at one point, but now have light sensation due to this gene therapy. And I think what's exciting here is that technology has finally caught up and allowed us to capitalize on existing technology, technology that is billions of years old, that of the virus and the algae, allowing us to combine it in such a way that we might be at a point where we could at least hope for a a cure for blindness. Thank you.